Good morning, children. So we have returned back to our class. That is, thank you, ma'am. Okay, we have been doing this chapter. Yesterday also we have done. The last day also we have done this chapter. So again we'll be continuing with this chapter. Okay, thank you, ma'am. So first of all, when you all started writing in your copies, first you all have written the name of the chapter. That is, thank you, ma'am. Okay. Now the next, what you have written down, just see here. Next, we have written down these. Some thanksgiving notes, okay? Where we say thank you, or where we are thankful to God for everything that He provides us, okay? Now the next part. Just see here, I have given you all pictures of all the houses of God. You all can draw anyone or all the four, and we feel thankful that we are under the blessings of God. Okay. Now the next. Just see here. I have given you all a pen picture, a small gist of the total chapter. Thank you, ma'am. Okay. What has been said to us in the chapter and what we learned from the chapter. I'll be writing down in the question answers, which we'll be doing today. Okay. This is the writer, the picture of the writer you might not be knowing. Okay, that's why I've just noted it down. I've just brought the picture of the writer here for you all to see. Here's the writer, here's Langston Hughes, who has written thank you, ma'am, for us. Okay. Now here, see, I've written down about the writer. Okay, this is about the writer, when he was born, when he died, what are his writings about and all. Okay, you all are going to note all these things down in your copies so that you all remember when you all go through the chapter, you all can just know the basic of the chapter. Okay, what is the base of the chapter? Okay. Now here are 10 spellings which I have given you all beforehand. Please note down the spellings in your notebooks. Okay, learn it up because you all will need the spellings while writing down your answers. Okay. Here are the meanings. These meanings you should know. I have just told you all about the meanings beforehand. Okay. Still, today I am telling you all there are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 meanings there, okay? One is pocketbook, which is a wallet or a purse. The next is stoop. Stoop means to bend one head or body forward and downward, okay? Frail, which is weak and delicate. When we are frail, we become weak and we become delicate also. Willow wild, that is a thin as a willow tree. As thin as a willow tree, you all have seen willow trees, a pine tree, and just as wild also as a willow tree by nature. Okay. The next is kitchenette. What is kitchenette? A small kitchen or a part of a room which is equipped as a kitchen, which is used, equipments are there as a kitchen. Okay. The next is suede. What is suede? Rough leather which is without a shine. He needed sweatshoes. He wanted sweatshoes, Rogers. That means he needed a shoe. He wanted a shoe with rough leather there without shine. The next is screen. What is screen? I told you all last day also. A fixed or movable partition which we generally hang within our homes to just give a partition to our rooms. Okay. The next is lima beans. Okay, an edible round green colored bean which we have for our salads and all. Okay, blonde is light colored hair. Okay, so this much you all have written down all these. Now the next part. Okay, see, answer the following questions. Now I've written down all the 5 questions which I've given there. I'll just read for you all also so that it's easy for you all to understand. Okay. Now, number 1. What happened when the boy tried to pull the bag off Mrs. Jones' shoulder? What happened? When the boy ran up behind Mrs. Jones, Mrs. Luella Bates Washington Jones, and tried to snatch her purse, what happened? The strap broke with a single tug. With a single tug, the strap of the bag broke away. But the boy's weight and the weight of the purse combined together and caused the boy to lose balance and fall down. Okay, this is the answer there. Now, number two. Why did Mrs. Luella Bates Washington Jones decide to take the boy home? Why did she do so? She could have taken him to the police station also. Okay. Why? Mrs. Luella Bates Washington Jones decided to take him home because he looked as if he were 14 or 15. He was a very small boy. Okay. He was frail and willow-wild. He was frail. Frail means weak and willow-wild. Very thin. And he did not look very homely also. Okay. He was there standing in tennis shoes. Okay. And blue jeans. He was not very well dressed also. He was hungry, he said. He said he hadn't taken food from the morning. And he was dirty all over too. That is why Mrs. Luella Jones, Luella Bates Washington Jones, she felt sympathy for the boy. Okay. And she took him home. Understood? Now then, number three. What did she ask him to do when they reached her house? When they reached her house, she could have behaved in a improper manner also because he was stealing her purse. But she did not do so. What did she do? She asked him to clean himself up and to have some food with her. Whatever she had, the food which was kept for her, she shared that food with the boy. Okay. A very, very, what to say, a very good manner. That is what we expect from Luella Bates Washington Jones. Okay, we expect, but the boy actually, did he expect? No, but still, he got such good man, such good behavior from the lady. Okay, now the next. Number four. Why did the author use Mrs. Jones' full name when describing her? The author, you will find everywhere, he is using the full name of Mrs. Jones. Why? The author used Mrs. Luella Bates Washington Jones' full name in order to show her importance in the chapter. Actually, this in the chapter, it's Mrs. Jones who is teaching us everything. Teaching us to love people who are in need. Teaching us to take care of those people who are not in the right path. Teaching us to bring society in a new turn. Okay, she is teaching us everything in this chapter. So her part is very important in the chapter. Okay, that is why we find that the author uses Mrs. Luella Bates Washington Jones' full name in the chapter. Okay. Now the next, number five. Why couldn't the boy say anything when he was leaving the house? Sorry, here leaving will be L-E-A-V-I-N-G. Okay, let me see from your book. Just see here. See here, it's given L-E-A-V-I-N-G. Okay. Please correct it while you're all right. Okay. I'll just correct the thing and give you all as PDF. Okay. But still here, it will be L-E-A-V-I-N-G. Okay. Leaving the house. The boy wanted to say something else other than thank you, ma'am, to Mrs. Luella Bates Washington Jones. But he couldn't do so. As he turned at the Baron's stoop and looked back at the large woman in the door, he barely managed to say thank you. Okay, when he just turned back, he had no other words in his mouth. He managed to say thank you before she shut the door and he never saw her again. She shut the door and she went inside because she didn't even expect a thank you from this boy. Okay, because she felt that it was her duty to do so. So she did not expect thank you from Roger. But Rogers, he wanted to say many things other than thank you, but he could not. Okay, when he turned around and looked at the lady, he also felt some amount of love and some amount of, affection for her. So every word in his mouth had stopped there, and he could only say thank you. Okay, children, so this much what you all are going to do. Okay, so thank you, children. Okay, this much for today. Please note down your question answers and you all send me your copies for checking. Okay.